University of Minnesota Duluth student who suffered severe hypothermia. Friends dropped off 19-year-old Alyssa Jo Lommel by her home on Woodland Avenue in Duluth on Friday night. She was found unconscious the next morning outside her neighbor's house. Five Eyewitness News reporter Beth McDonough is live in the newsroom with the details on this. Beth?
Yeah. Eric, Alyssa Lommel's family is at the hospital. They didn't want to talk on camera, but they tell us that they are grateful for your thoughts and your prayers, and she needs them. There are real fears that she could lose a hand, a foot, or more because of that extreme cold. Imagine being outside when it's 17 below zero with wind chills at 25 below.
Alyssa Lommel is in the burn center of Regents Hospital, which specializes in injuries from extreme cold. She is alive, but she is not out of the woods. Her family told us in person she's doing better, but referred us to Alyssa's Caring Bridge site for more. Her mom, Terry, says the 19-year-old's been through several procedures to restore blood flow to her daughter's hands and feet, and she's been through skin grafts. Amputation is a real concern. The severe damage done after Alyssa, a UMD student, was exposed here in the harshest of elements for hours on end.
I was kind of disappointed to see that, like, someone would be left out on the porch in negative 0 degree weather.
Duluth police confirmed what a post on Lommel's Twitter page suggested Friday: tequila shots tonight. Alcohol was a factor. Authorities say she'd been out partying with friends and was dropped off at her home on Woodland about midnight. Officers say tracks in the snow indicate an inebriated Lommel, who had her house keys, mistakenly wandered to the wrong house, an empty house next door.
And then I didn't understand why she went to her neighbor's, and I don't know. It just seemed like a really confusing situation that probably shouldn't have happened.
A passerby found Lommel out cold on the porch at 9:30 the next morning. Her life in jeopardy because of hypothermia then, and now because of infections and significant injuries.
There is a long road of recovery ahead. Alyssa's family says that she is alert and conscious. She knows what's going on, but still can't talk because of breathing tubes. So she hasn't been able to tell anyone what happened. Relatives are praying tonight that Alyssa's body will respond to treatment to save her hands and feet. We're all pulling for it. Live in the newsroom, Beth McDonough, Five Eyewitness News.